Now I'm here with Philip. And Philip, you were in the building with your daughter. Can you describe where in the building you were when this happened?
Well, kind of where you see the missing part of the building. We're up on that second floor close to that part of the building in a counselor's office. My daughter's a senior here this year, and we were coming in to have a counselor's meeting, just senior prep stuff. And she's also on a basketball team, so the only other set of kids in the building were the girls in the gym preparing for basketball practice. And we went up to our meeting and we're talking to the counselor, and another staff member that we also know too came in and said, we need everybody out of the building, we smell gas. And seconds after that, my daughter got up and was getting ready to leave out of the counselor's office and was blown back into the counselor's office by the explosion. I mean, it was seconds after they told us to everybody to get out that the explosion happened. So it was pretty crazy.
It was forceful enough that it blew your daughter back?
Oh, yeah. Yep. All the windows in the office where we were in blew out. The rubble from the ceiling and everything came tumbling down. The counselor that we're meeting with is getting ready to, she's pregnant and getting ready for maternity leave and you know, after I made sure my wife and daughter were okay, we both were like, oh, you know, where's Miss Overton? And she happened to be, she jumped under the desk to stop from all the falling debris. And then we all gathered ourselves and helped them get out.
So you said your daughter's okay, your wife's okay, everyone else that you were with is okay?
Yep. And then my next reaction was the girls are here, because I actually dropped a couple of the girls off for practice, and then we proceeded up to our meeting, ran right down to the gym to try to see if I couldn't get wherever the girls were to just, you know, we're a real close family with the basketball team, and then even the staff and family here that at Minnehaha is it's a small community. So, you know, you start seeing staff that you see every day and just making sure everybody's okay. And so a couple of us kind of jumped back into action and just tried to help out as much as we could.
So you're in there. That must have been terrifying. Debris starts coming down. The windows blow out. What was your immediate reaction? You said it was to go help other people, not to run out of the building.
No, I mean, I don't know what that's about, but that's just kind of something that, you know, I was raised to do. So you made sure my wife and daughter were okay, and we went out of a back door with Miss Overton. And then when, you know, initially you see the things that are going on immediately where you are, but then when I came out and saw everything else, that's when it was like, oh my goodness, people are in there. And so the basketball coach, a really good friend of mine, and then the athletic director, we all kind of were trying to jump back in there and see if we could. We had some people stuck on the roof, we were looking for ladders, so it was pretty intense situation.
I want to get back to that rescue in a moment, but just to make sure I understand the timeline here, who came in and told you that they smelled gas?
One of the other staff members, and I'm blanking out on her name right now, but we know each other from just being here for a few years now, and she just, you know, she came in, and we were worried about her too, but she had already gone back into the hallway, and that's where the explosion, we felt like the explosion came from. So there was another door in the counselor's office, and I asked her, what's that door? And she's like, it's a back hallway to a staircase. I'm like, okay, we're going that way. Then when I got out here, we saw that staff member out here too. So she made it out okay too.
She made it out as well.
When we went back in, if you look right where it's all kind of fallen, we always cut through there to get, that's the cafeteria area. And we cut through there to get to this larger building, which is the gym. And there, like that hallway, is complete rubble from floor to ceiling. We went in there, maybe thought when we heard the moaning, maybe thought that there was somebody in that way, and you can't even walk that way anymore.
You heard moaning?
That was one of the things that happened. We started the basketball coach, athletic director, myself heard somebody and kept yelling out for them to respond back. We heard it a few times and didn't hear any response. And then by that time, first responders were here. And so they, you know, we were escorted out the building and they took over.
So we know that three people right now at the last count are unaccounted for.
That's what I heard too, yeah.
What does that feel like knowing you got out and there's people inside?
I mean, you know, nothing but blessed. And also, I think that's part of the reason why you still got so many people here. Like I was saying earlier, it's, you know, it's a tight-knit community. And so a lot of people are trying to figure out who it is, just make sure to see if we can, you know, if they're still in there or what the case might be.
How did the girls respond when they got outside? I mean, these are teenagers.
Yeah. Fortunately for the ones in the gym, they said it sounded more like a door slamming. And so I think they didn't realize the magnitude of it until they got out. And, you know, I worried about my daughter a little bit. About 2 months ago, was T-boned by a police officer that ran a red light and totaled her car, almost flipped her car over. And a month later, you know, a couple months later, she's in the middle of an explosion. So I, you know, she's a tough one, but you know, I mean, it's only to be expected that something. So we'll keep an eye on that for sure.
Did you smell gas?
Not until somebody said something like, oh yeah, you know, but it still wasn't. I mean, you know, you have gas leaks at home, you know, it's an important thing to move quickly, but that you don't expect that at all. That felt like some, you know, I felt like we got bombed. Like it was pretty big. It was a pretty big explosion.
And did you see flames then? I mean, now we're just seeing the destruction, but earlier there were flames and smoke.
When we went back in to try to start helping folks or see if there was anybody else, there was I got to a part of the cafeteria that was completely on fire. And that's when we kind of started thinking, you know, and you start thinking secondary explosion, other things. And so we were kind of trying to help, but also keep in mind that, you know, we're not sure structurally what's going to happen or whatever. But luckily it all happened in a matter of minutes by the time first responders got here and everything else. So it was probably 5 or 10 minutes that we were even helping out before, you know, there was way more help with more experience than us.
Well, I'm so grateful you and your family are okay. You must be feeling that right now.
Yeah, very much so, very much so. And then, you know, like I said, to go from that to seeing, you know, to then wondering where are all these girls at, you know, we're all like family. So, and then thinking about, you know, social media and everything else, and parents are going to start seeing stuff and want to know their kids are okay. So I just made sure we started calling all our parents and making sure the girls contacted their families.
And then finally, we hear that there were 5 people, I think was the last report, transported to HCMC, to the hospital. Did you see what kind of injuries? Were people severely hurt?
Yeah, there was one lady on the roof who was bleeding from a few different places, looked like glass. We asked her. That's when we, you know, seeing how badly she was hurt, but she did have 2 other staff up there with her that, you know, were debris covered but didn't seem as injured. And we started asking them, is there anybody else up there with you? And they were confirming that there were other people up there that they didn't have an accounting for and things like that. And so that's that whole area that we were in. They actually escaped out of a broken window onto the roof. They couldn't get down the stairs, so it was pretty intense.
The people on the roof that we're hearing about, were they construction workers or were they school employees?
They were school employees. No, she dressed, you know, had her business suit on, business dress on, and was on the second floor. They were all here working, had their name tags and the whole 9 yards.
On top of the roof, though?
Yep. That's the only way they, I don't know if the stairway was blocked or whatever they did, but they came out of that window and were right where that ladder is.
Well, thank you so much for your time. Again, thoughts and prayers to you and your family and the whole school community.
Yep. Thank you.